your mind is everything. Your mind is your biggest tool. And if you can imagine something, you can create it. The most rewarding thing is, you know, seeing your ideas and your concepts come to life and knowing that everything that you imagine is possible. My name is Mimi Shadende and I'm a designer based in London. We are in my lighting manufacturers, Denny and Hamlin. We are working on a few new lighting pieces for some projects in London and in Kuwait. It's a lot of fun. It's a great working relationship. So usually it starts off with me sending them a concept that I have, and they come back with, you know, suggestions, and I usually come in and we go through drawings, mock up models, and that's kind of where the concept really, you know, develops, when I kind of get to see it in CAD form or get to see like a miniature model of it. Art was my original calling, so I do design from more of an artistic angle rather than a technical angle. It definitely has informed my work because I do think my design process is kin to sculpture. The space comes first, and when I design the space, I then the pieces follow after. I'm very proud Nigerian, and I feel very proud to be British as well. I think anything that automatically comes from me will be, you know, a reflection of my heritage and my interpretation growing up as a Nigerian Brit. I am influenced a lot by my culture. You know, if you look back at my, you know, earliest collections, you know, me just from naming them, you know, Yoruba names, and you know, picking influences from, you know, my heritage. My mum is such a huge influence. My mum is super entrepreneurial, and she always kind of motivates me that, you know, you can do it, just keep going, keep fighting. How I started MimiNat was as a hobby. MimiNat was always at the back, you know, just developing and organically growing. Because I'm not trained as a furniture or lighting designer, it's so important to find a team, you know, a team that understands you and is willing to be patient with you and help you. You know, like my lighting makers, for example, they're a perfect example of that. You know, it's been such a lovely learning curve and experience. And as designers and just as people in general, you just never stop learning. The most important thing is for me just to enjoy the process. And hopefully when I get the chance to, you know, go back home and give back and help other young female African designers who, you know, don't have the opportunity or the exposure to, I guess, to pursue their dreams. So that would be something I would love to do. So it's maybe to open up a design school. That would be lovely future. And I think that's kind of when I can give myself a pat on the back and say, yeah, I did it.